The following program is made possible by generous gifts from partners of Benny Hinn Ministries and viewers like you in this area.
Pastor Benny Hinn is urgently preaching the gospel to the lost because the world's only hope is salvation through God's only Son, Jesus Christ.
The gift of God is life eternal.
This is your day to join Benny Hinn in proclaiming Jesus as Savior and Healer.
This is your day from Orlando, Florida. Oh, I love this. With me today is Dr. Don Colbert. We are going to talk about something very, very important, and that is how to stay healthy for the rest of your life. Listen, precious saints, Jesus wants you whole. He wants you healthy because He loves you. He cares for you. And today He has given us gifts like Don Colbert, who is brilliant in my opinion and a genius when it comes to health and nutrition. Weight loss. It's a big deal today in America.
Absolutely. In fact, in America, but also the world, realize two-thirds of Americans are either overweight or obese.
Now, you said something amazing that I want you all to hear. 35 major diseases are connected to obesity.
Yes, 35 major diseases, including, of course, heart disease, type 2 diabetes, high blood pressure, high cholesterol, gallbladder disease, sleep apnea, but also over a dozen cancers, Alzheimer's disease. And I like to tell people that Jesus received 39 stripes for our diseases to clear our diseases up. And by choosing to be overweight and obese, we literally sign up for 35 major diseases. So again, we need to help our people.
Listen, Doc, I believe with all of my heart, God wants us healthy and whole. Now, back 2,000 years ago, they did not eat the foods we eat today.
Correct.
So today we're eating sugars and
yes.
foods that are man-made.
Yes.
That are causing us to get sick.
Oh, absolutely.
Even though after God heals us, we still get sick often because we're eating this stuff that's hurting us. Let's make 2013 our year of health.
Praise God. Amen.
Help us, Doc. We
well,
want to know.
It's simple. I have to explain to the patient out there that it's the foods that we choose to eat. And unfortunately, man has extracted the sugar out of the sugar cane. He's used high fructose corn syrup, processed foods that spike the blood sugar. And people are saying, well, you know, I'm avoiding sugar or I'm avoiding fats, but I'm not losing weight. Well, it's the spike in blood sugar that releases insulin levels that programs the body for fat storage. And so what's so exciting is we have ways to change our diet and to take a few key supplements that keeps that blood sugar from spiking, which programs our body for weight gain.
Let me ask you, when did all this begin? When did this problem with weight really begin in America? What was it, in the 50s, the 60s,
well,
what?
It was mainly in the 70s with fast foods coming, flourishing on most every street corner with the McDonald's and the Burger Kings and the Pizza Huts and the Taco Bells and all the processed foods. See, the thing that very few people realize is that when you eat processed food, it's been highly processed with lots of wheat and corn and starches
but
and white potatoes.
We all enjoy the taste, Doc.
Yes, so, I know.
I mean, I know. You know,
yes.
People, okay, we can't eat pizza, can't eat this.
Well,
but
I'm not saying.
We want to enjoy some of that stuff.
Yes.
Is there a healthy side to it?
There is, and that's what's exciting, is once you learn how to combine some foods and fibers and certain supplements, we don't get that blood sugar spike. And when you don't get that blood sugar spike, you turn your insulin levels down and your body starts burning fat. And it's so easy. I've been doing this now for the past couple of years, and I've been putting patients on, of course, low sugar, low glycemic diets, not the high glycemic diets, boosting their fiber, giving them some incredible supplements that reduce that blood sugar.
And you've seen change.
Yes, I see some amazing changes that occur. But again, it's best if we can combine the diet, the exercise, with a few key supplements.
Well, you know, what do you think about that China study? Some doctors
oh,
did
yes.
the China study.
The China study was very good.
Were reversing people's diseases, diabetes, heart disease, even
yes.
cancer.
Yes, and that's what, and the China study is a vegetarian diet. It's a very good study. And again, that was God's first intention, was for us to be vegetarians. It tells us that in Genesis. But what's happened is now Jesus said, you know, that we can pretty much have certain meats, but what Americans have done is they've taken meats and they get huge portion sizes. If we could just limit our animal protein.
When you say Jesus, you mean in the New Testament?
Well,
we're given permission to eat whatever.
Right, in Acts 15, God has blessed,
and so on. I mean, there's a lot of controversies on this one.
Right.
On what did that mean? But still, you know, God has given us all things to enjoy. We just have to be careful with
moderation.
What gets into our bodies.
Sure.
So we don't get sick and harmed. But, Doc, let's talk about health first, and then we're going to talk about weight loss.
Right.
Okay, what are the key things we need to do as Christians to stay healthy or turn our situation around? Let's make 2013, truly, I mean, as our year of health. We all know God heals us, wants to heal us, but let's stay healed.
Correct.
By eating right.
Right.
Give us just the simple things we need to start doing this year.
Well, the first thing we need to do is realize the big problem here in America is the obesity epidemic and the diseases that are fueled by obesity. So again, the thing that triggers this mostly are our highly sugared drinks. Now, this includes sodas. This includes your sweet coffees, even your juices, which are healthy, most people believe. But these are spiking our blood sugar. So I start by telling people, instead of the high sugar drinks and the smoothies, which so many people think are healthy, that raise your blood sugar, let's stick more with water and unsweetened teas, or teas with stevia, or green tea, or black tea, or white tea, any of the teas, or the sparkling waters.
But if we can use do this honey.
Well, again, we got to be careful with the sweeteners, because that's high in fructose, which can also spike your sugar
so
and cause a fatty liver.
So the first thing you need to do is lower your sugars.
The first thing you want to do, the thing that's causing probably the greatest increase in obesity is being caused by these sugar sweetened drinks. It's like liquid sugar.
Okay, but our bodies need sugar. So what are the good sugars?
Well, let's talk about the way we're designed. The way we live the longest and the healthiest is when we eat sugars that are low glycemic or low glycemic starches and plant foods. That's what our body's meant to run on. Because let me explain the way it works. When we eat a food, especially a carbohydrate or a fruit, it's broken down into sugar, glucose, which is then absorbed into the bloodstream. But we want that sugar to be trickled into the bloodstream instead of a rush of sugar into the bloodstream. When there's a rush of sugar into the bloodstream, what happens then is there's an increase in insulin.
Okay.
Now, insulin is a double-edged sword, because insulin, when it rises high, it'll actually cause your body to store fat. And that's what's happening. It's too many people are choosing white rice, white bread, a lot of bread and corn products, as well as sweetened drinks, which raise the sugar, raise the insulin, and they're being programmed for fat gain, especially in the belly, but all over. So the first thing I like to tell people is, first, let's focus on our beverages, because the beverages seem to spike that sugar level and insulin level more than anything else.
So the first thing we need to do is lower our sugars. And now, precious saints, listen, at the end of the program, we're going to talk about a supplement that's going to help you lose weight. That really works, from what I gather from a lot of
Absolutely.
People. It's becoming quite popular, quite famous. But before we go there, let's just talk more about what must we do to get healthier.
And then what we want to do is we want to start eating at least three good meals a day with one or two healthy snacks. Now, so many people are skipping breakfast.
Can we go back to sugar just a
sure.
second? Fruit. We surely can eat fruit daily.
Now, fruit is fine. There's
okay.
absolutely, but then there's higher glycemic fruits and low glycemic fruits. See, the glycemic index is an important principle. It tells us how fast sugar is absorbed into the bloodstream. Foods that are high glycemic have a glycemic index over 70. Foods that are low glycemic index have
What fruits are good?
Well, berries.
Okay.
They're low glycemic. Granny Smith apples are low glycemic, as well as these are probably the lowest glycemic fruits that we have. But again, if you have the fruit juice, that's more high glycemic.
So eating fruit rather than drinking juices.
Yes, but bananas, ripe bananas, will raise your blood sugar. See, it gives you too much fructose, which can cause an elevation in your blood sugar and an increase in fat in your liver. So again, that's why you want a moderation. I'm not saying don't ever eat bananas again. I'm just saying moderation, smaller amounts. Choose more low glycemic fruits.
Okay, lower your sugars. That's number one. Second, what?
Well, second would be planning your meals. And so many people skip breakfast. Breakfast is the most important meal of the day. They've done studies on people that eat cereal for breakfast, and those people lost weight. They've done studies on people that even eat pancakes, and oatmeal for breakfast, they lose weight. The key is eating a breakfast, but it's even more important to eat a healthy, well-balanced breakfast, okay? Along with a healthy...
And breakfasts are important because...
Well, breakfast gets the metabolic rate going. Okay. See, so many people suffer from a sluggish metabolic rate. When you go 12 hours without eating, it's kind of like I tell people, like building a forest fire at night or a campfire at night. When you build a campfire at night, it's burning bright. But then by the morning or dawn, the embers are just barely going. That's similar to our metabolic fires, our metabolic rate. When we go without eating for 12 hours, our metabolic rate becomes sluggish and we don't burn the calories that we could provided we eat a breakfast. It gets our metabolic fires burning. It increases our metabolic rate.
So breakfast is important, but just talk more about that
breakfast
second
is important
key.
As far as eating about every 3 to 4 hours well-balanced meals, because here's what so many Americans do. So many Americans will skip breakfast or eat a bagel and a cup of coffee for breakfast. And then about noon, they're starving. So they go and they get a candy bar. They go and they get something that'll raise the blood sugar rapidly, which is generally a sweet beverage or a donut or a candy bar or, you know, a lot of starch, a lot of high glycemic starch that spikes the blood sugar, spikes the insulin, programs the body for weight gain. And then what happens is when you eat that food that's high in sugar, the insulin level goes up and then it drives the sugar down. So mid-afternoon, they get tired, lethargic, and then they get real hungry. And so they eat another snack. And so their blood sugar goes up, their insulin level goes up, they store fat, they're in fat storage mode. And then all of a sudden, a few hours later, they crash. So at nighttime, they're starving. So they eat dinner, and usually they're craving starches, potatoes, corn, breads, all those high glycemic starches that, again, raises their blood sugar. Then they're snacking at night on snacks such as, you know, a piece of cake or a piece of pie or ice cream or
cereal.
But
it's not bad to eat at night, though, like late at night.
It's not bad eating at night, provided you're eating more low glycemic carbs
and proteins.
You know,
it's really interesting that in Spain, dinner begins at 9 p.m. in many homes. Yet they don't have the diseases we have.
Well, let's talk about that. That's a very good question. And again, that's because the Mediterranean mindset and lifestyle and diet. Because what they do is they make dining an experience. Whereas here in America, when we sit down at a restaurant or for dinner, what happens? You just look around at the tables and people are just eating real fast. They eat real fast. They chew a couple of bites. They wash it down. And within 15 minutes, you know, they've eaten most of their meal. Whereas in Spain, in Italy, in France, they first of all sit with the family, they talk, they eat small amounts, they savor each bite. It's called mindfulness, enjoying the present moment, savor in the present moment. So what happens is they're able to eat just a few bites, enjoy those bites, and get full. So it takes 20 minutes for the appetite center in the hypothalamus of the brain to tell you you're full. Well, these people are sitting around for an hour and a half, 2 hours. So they just eat a little amount, they savor.
You're using words I bet you some people have not even heard before. But it's okay, though. Okay. I'm enjoying listening to you, Doc. Mm-hmm. Go ahead, please.
But what happens, the key to this, is they don't eat the huge portion sizes. Whereas you go to any American restaurant, they get a plate full of pasta or potatoes.
I mean, I went to a restaurant in Spain, supposedly the oldest in the world. They opened their doors at 9 p.m. We were there at 1 a.m. in the morning.
Yes.
Place was packed, people eating. I'm thinking, okay, they tell us not to eat at night.
Right.
Those people eat late at night, and they're all healthy.
They are.
And that's because they eat
because of the concept of mindfulness, enjoying the present moment. But that's the key. Small amounts is the key.
Give us the
small portion sizes.
Give us the third key to turning our health around in 2013.
Well, the third key would be most likely to simply get the amount of sleep that you need. They've done studies on sleep and stress reduction, and lack of sleep causes people to overeat.
Now, you said earlier that losing weight will help you sleep.
Well, it does, because so many people are having sleep problems here in the U.S. because they're obese and they have sleep apnea. And when you have sleep apnea, their palate sags down and blocks their breathing passages, and they're waking up 10, 20, 30, 100 times a night in order to catch a breath, so they don't enter that deep restorative sleep.
Is there anything else you want to say before we get into weight loss that I really want to talk about?
Well, also, there's many things that are real important. Exercise, regular exercise is important. Again, learning to cope with stress is so important. And adequate sleep. Those are important because if you neglect any one of those, you're going to be more prone to gain weight.
Now, let's talk about losing weight because a lot of people want to lose weight.
And we have a supplement we're going to talk to you about that will help you lose weight that we'll tell you about at the end of the program. Talk about that. Just open up and help us understand how to lose weight.
Well, the first thing, in order to lose weight, you have to start with a healthy breakfast. A healthy breakfast. I've written 5 books on weight loss over the years. I wrote the book.
Well, and a healthy breakfast helps you lose weight because?
Well, because you're getting the metabolic rate revved up. You're getting the metabolic. See, what happens is people skip breakfast, their metabolic rate decreases so literally, and then they start craving sugars and starches, which set them on a weight gain problem
so
because their insulin levels are going
to be. So how do these supplements help? I mean, if they can do the right things, they won't need the supplements we're going to talk about today.
Well, if most people, unfortunately, they don't do the right things. They're going to cheat. But again, even if you do the right things, realize 79 million Americans in this country have prediabetes and 26 million have diabetes.
Explain prediabetes.
Prediabetes is the stage before diabetes, when they're in that elevated blood sugar.
They
don't have
any
symptoms. You only know from blood tests, like a hemoglobin A1C or fasting blood sugar. If your fasting blood sugar is between 100 and 125, you have prediabetes. Or if your hemoglobin A1C, which is a marker of what your sugar has been over the last 3 months, is 5.7 to 6.49, you have prediabetes, which means you're headed toward diabetes. Now, with diabetes, what happens is then you start getting into all the problems, the cardiovascular risk factors, the nerve problems.
And you know, like you said earlier, it takes time. It's a process.
Correct.
Like of years before people get diabetes. Just it doesn't happen overnight.
But we can reverse that. In the pre-diabetic stage, it's easy to reverse with just changing the diet. And you asked me about a supplement, taking a supplement that reduces that blood sugar. And see, by reducing the blood sugar, what happens is you're not getting those sugar spikes, that insulin spikes, which triggers the pre-diabetes and the type 2 diabetes.
Okay, before we talk about the supplement, keep talking about how do we lose weight? What are the things we have to do besides eating breakfast?
Okay, then it's the right combination of foods. And this is what is so important. I tell patients, most of my patients eat way too much sugar, way too much high glycemic starch like white bread, white potatoes, corn products. Even whole wheat can raise your sugar, boost the sugar.
Wow.
So as well as, you know, even if you eat too much of a starch, pasta, that'll raise your sugar. So again, now small amounts is okay, but I put my patients on a low glycemic starches like sweet potatoes, like beans and peas and legumes. You say, well, what's the difference in this type of starch, wheat, versus, you know, peas and legumes and beans? Well, it's a special type of starch. The wheat contains amylopectin A. Now, it's real important you understand this. Amylopectin A is a type of starch. 75% of wheat, even whole wheat, even your Ezekiel bread and sprouted bread contain this starch. What it does, this starch is absorbed very rapidly. So it raises the blood sugar, which spikes the insulin, and it gets you started. It literally sets the signals off, the high insulin, for weight gain. It's telling your body, store fat, store fat, store fat. So what I'm telling people, instead of the amylopectin A, let's choose more amylose, which is in your beans, peas, and legumes, and lentils. These contain amylose, which trickle the blood sugar into the bloodstream rather than that spike that occurs when you eat a lot of corn and a lot of wheat products. See, grains typically spike the blood sugar, and that's what most people don't understand. America eats way too many grains. When you eat a lot of grains, you're going to spike the blood sugar, spike the insulin, and program your body for weight gain, especially belly fat. So the answer is this, making the correct combinations of foods, eating lots of greens, lots of salads. Starting the meal off with a salad with extra virgin olive oil and vinegar is beautiful. That's a good monounsaturated fat that's non-inflammatory fat. And also soups, your bean soups, your black bean soups, your lentil soups, your vegetable soups, your minestrone soups. Those are really good because they're very filling. Works on a volumetric principle. So you're a salad with a bean soup, small portions of protein. You know, we don't need a lot of protein. Most Americans eat way too much protein. Animal protein is what I'm talking about. Plant protein's fine. But the animal protein, I try and get my women eating 3 to 4 ounces of protein.
Is too much not good?
Too much protein creates too many organic acids that eventually can set a person up for gout. Also, it makes the body acidic, the tissues acidic, and it eventually sets the body up for disease. That's the whole premise of the China study. with Dr. T. Colin Campbell. And again, he's right in a way. And when my patients have cancer, I put them on the China study diet because.
But I mean, for a short time, though, not for life.
Yes, for life.
Really?
For life, yes. If a person is battling cancer.
Off all proteins.
Not off all protein, all animal protein.
Yes, okay.
I put them on plant proteins because it's healthier. He's shown it. And what's amazing in this study, and it's an amazing study, is he found that when he lowered he actually did a study in mice, when he lowered the animal protein to less than 10%, now he induced cancer in these mice, but when he lowered the protein content to less than 10% animal protein, guess what started happening? The tumor started regressing. They started decreasing in size.
Well, I tell you what, if you're struggling with cancer or you know someone who is, please get hold of a DVD called Forks Over Knives.
It's excellent, the China study.
By the same doctors. It's called Forks, like a fork over knives. It'll really help you.
Absolutely.
You know, and they talk about the, you know, vegetarian diet. But there's some questions on that, too, on, you know.
There are.
But it'll help you. There's
the majority
no
of people, I find, can't do it. It's a wonderful program. Like I said, that was God's first intention, was for us to be vegetarian. But again, most Americans don't do it. Most of my patients can't do it. So what we do is we offer balance, a balanced approach. By, like I said, starting with your salad with a healthy salad dressing like olive oil and vinegar, using some bean, lentil, or vegetable soup, and then combine it, right, making the right combinations with a healthy protein, but not a lot of animal protein, only 3 to 4 ounces for women, 3 to 6 ounces for men, once or twice a day. That's it. That's usually less 10% or less of animal protein, which is good. That's
Give us just one more thing before we talk about this supplement.
And then, like I say, healthy fats as well as healthy starches like the beans, peas, legumes, lentils, sweet potatoes are also good. A little wild rice or brown rice instead of white rice. And you've got a real good combination there, the right fuel mixture to keep that blood sugar from going high, which helps your body lose weight. It's real simple. And then doing that, breakfast,
well,
lunch, and dinner.
It's simple for you, Doug.
I've been doing it all my life.
I've
written 5 books on this over
the years.
Well,
listen, they do have a supplement out that can help you.
Yes.
Let's talk about this. It's right here. It's called Pure Green Coffee Bean Extract. Why does this help?
Well, first of all, this is a supplement. It's been validated by a double-blind placebo-controlled study. Now, that is the gold standard in medicine, is a double-blind placebo-controlled study. It was actually published in a medical journal, which is the Diabetes, the Metabolic Syndrome.
It says here it supports weight loss.
Correct.
Supports fat burning. Supports healthy glucose.
But let's talk about green coffee bean. You say, what is green coffee bean?
Yeah, I've not heard of it till just recently.
Most people haven't, but the study was amazing. This study went on for 22 weeks, and on average, the people in this study lost 17.5 pounds in 22 weeks without really changing their diet, without increasing their activity, and with no side effects. So it's an amazing study, and the key to this is 400 milligrams of green coffee bean containing at least 45% chlorogenic acid. Now you say, what's chlorogenic acid? Well, first of all, when you roast coffee, the darker the roast, the lower the chlorogenic acid. Chlorogenic acid is an amazing phytonutrient that lowers the blood sugar. This has about 3 key mechanisms to helping you burn fat or get the weight off. First of all, it inhibits the absorption of sugar and fat.
Really? Wow.
So that's one mechanism. Number two, it has a thermogenic effect. Thermogenic means a fat-burning effect. It helps the liver to actually burn the fat. It also...
Who came up with this?
Well, this has been out for just a short period of time, just for really a couple of years.
But what studies, doctors?
Well, the studies, this was a study that was actually done in a medical journal, diabetes and metabolic syndrome and obesity journal. And it was a study, like I say, for 22 weeks on 16 different participants, 8 men, 8 women. And they found they lost 17.5 pounds in 22 weeks. And without changing their diet, they didn't change their diet, they ate the same, exercised the same, and they didn't have any side effects. Now, what they found is the reason this works is it works best if people take this pill 30 minutes before each meal. And what the chlorogenic acid does, and the key to this product is the chlorogenic acid.
And the people that have been helped... Now, how many of them you said they did this study on?
It was 16 people, 8 men, 8 women. But it was a gold standard study in medicine.
And I'm hearing a lot about this right now from a lot of people that actually they're taking this and they say it really works.
Well, I've been using it now for well over a year in my patients, and I've been using it also for my diabetic patients. And again, what we find is it keeps that blood sugar from spiking up, which keeps the insulin from spiking.
So it helps diabetics too, wow.
Oh, absolutely. It programs the body for weight loss. That's
and
what's so exciting about
it. Pure green coffee bean extract supports weight loss, supports fat burning, and supports healthy glucose, clinically proven. What makes this different than other coffee bean extracts?
Well, first of all, it's pharmaceutical grade. It's made in a veggie cap instead of a gelatin cap, which most supplements are in gelatin caps. Also, it can, instead of containing the filler, say they have excipients or fillers they put in capsules, that most contain silica. This has a natural ingredient called parsley leaf extract that we use as a filler, which is a natural filler instead of sand. Silica is just sand. And plus, it's made in a GMP facility, which are good manufacturing practices, which means they're regulated actually by the FDA. So it's
wow.
It's a very high-quality product.
This container here with 60 capsules, you can get it for a gift of $50 to the ministry. It'll really make a difference in your health. Doc, I mean, this is really quite a miraculous supplement, isn't
Pastor, it? Pastor, it's amazing because, again, even if people cheat, the thing that's so good about this is green coffee bean extract keeps that sugar from spiking, which keeps the insulin from spiking, which turns off the programming that so many people have to store fat. It turns that off or turns it down significantly.
Call the number on the screen today. This is going to really be a blessing to your health and life. Call the number on the screen today and get your own pure green coffee bean extract. It's not often we talk about this, but I know what obesity has done to so many precious believers.
Absolutely.
Need to just lose the weight and get healthy again for Jesus' sake and their sake.
Absolutely. I tell people, you catch a cold, you catch the flu, but you develop obesity and diabetes by wrong choices and foods.
Well, do today, please. Be healthy. Stay healthy. In Jesus' name, we sure love you. Bye-bye.
Remember, if you want to lose weight fast, pure green coffee bean extract can help. Adding this supplement to your daily diet can not only promote healthy weight loss, but also aid in burning fat, increasing antioxidant activity, and balancing blood sugar levels. Call now to order your first 30-day supply for only $50. Getting your weight under control is an important step to improving your overall health, which can result in lower medical bills and a better quality of life. Call or order online and begin to feel good about yourself again. This month, Pastor Benny Hinn will visit South Africa for an extended series of miracle services in Johannesburg, Cape Town, Durban, and East London. And on Thursday, March 28th, Pastor Benny will be in Pensacola, Florida, to conduct one great miracle service at Brownsville Assembly of God. Then he'll hold his much-anticipated Good Friday Communion miracle service in Orlando at the Holy Land Experience on March 29th at 7 p.m. And the next day, Saturday, March 30th, Pastor Benny will be at Faith World in Orlando for a miracle service at 4 p.m.